You may not have heard about this. Apple literally has a no smoking ban regarding their products. If you smoke near an Apple computer, you void your warranty. Apple has been a really unusual company from the beginning. So, welcome to my top 16 things you should know about Apple. Let's begin. So guys, the no smoking ban is actually mentioned in the Apple's terms and conditions. As ridiculous as it sounds, if you smoke near an Apple computer, the Apple computers are capable of detecting the presence of nicotine in its surroundings, so it voids your warranty. It's just Apple's own way of saying that smoking is injurious to health. You might have known about Apple's co-founders Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak, but what most people don't know about is there was a third co-founder named Ronald Bain, who sold his 10% of share for just $800 and left the company just after 12 days it was formed. Had Bain stayed with the company, his shares would have worth $90 billion in 2020. Well, right now, after his retirement, he sells stamps and rare coins for his living. Mystery surrounded the reason behind the name Apple, but in truth, it was just the fruit Steve Jobs liked the most and named the company after that. The first ever Apple logo had Isaac Newton on it, which was designed by Ronald Bain, you know, the third co-founder. Later, the logo was made simple and with rainbow colors. It kept on changing before it reached to the minimalist logo we have these days. The bite on Apple was to make sure it was just an apple and not any other round-shaped fruit like an orange or a tomato. When Apple's Manhattan store was opened, over 10,000 people submitted applications to work, of which only 200 got selected, which is a 2% acceptance rate. Meanwhile, Harvard's acceptance rate was 7% at that time. It was harder to become an employee in Apple than to get into Harvard. Apple's terms and conditions say that Apple products should not be used to create nuclear or biohazard weapons. Again, just a fair one. Before Apple was actually found, Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak were previously working on a game developing company named Atari. The first Apple iPod, an Easter egg was implanted. Users could see and play a game called Breakout, which was developed by them while they were working for Atari. At a point in 2011, Apple was so much successful that it had twice the amount of cash on hand than the US Treasury. Hard to believe, but true. In 2018, Apple actually sold an average of 572,000 units of iPhones per day. In 2019, Apple actually grew to over 139,000 employees around the world, which is actually higher than the population of 40 other countries around the world. Even though Apple and Samsung have a pretty rough past mocking each other with their commercials, they are actually pretty codependent. One example is that Apple's displays are actually manufactured by Samsung. Since Samsung is one of the leading OLED display manufacturers in the industry, by doing this, Apple gets a quality display for their iPhones and Samsung gets to sell their displays to Apple. So it's kind of a win-win situation. Now this you might have noticed, every Apple product ad displays the time as 9:41. The first ever iPhone launch event started at 9 AM and the reveal of the iPhone was planned to happen 40 minutes from the start of the event. Steve Jobs wanted the actual time of reveal and the time on the product to be same. Steve Jobs was a true obsessive person towards tiny details. One day when he woke up, he found the yellow tint on the letter O of Google was slightly off on his iPhone and he immediately called Google's offices to report the issue. When the first Apple iPod was shown to Steve Jobs, he dropped it in an aquarium and used the air bubbles to prove that there was still empty space and it could be made smaller. Even with an estimated net worth of $7 billion for nearly 15 years as a CEO in the company, Steve Jobs was actually paid $1 a month so that he could qualify for the company's health benefits. Apple has been known for one of the best cameras on a smartphone, but that wasn't the company's first attempt. Apple was the first to make a digital color camera. Apple QuickTake 100 was launched in 1994. It could barely hold a total of 8 images at its maximum resolution, which is actually 640 by 480 pixels. It had no features of previewing or managing the photos on the device unless you hook it up to a Mac or a computer. In spite of all these flaws, it had a starting price of over $750. $750 in 1994 is a lot. Now this is pretty interesting. Apple's MacBook are actually made bulletproof. People around the world have put it to the test, but I would definitely not recommend you doing that. It might stop the bullets, but it would definitely kill the Mac. In 1986, Apple launched a new clothing line. They called it the Apple Collection. If that wasn't strange enough, take a look at what it actually looked like. To be honest, it might have been fashionable at that time, but I don't know, I leave this up to you guys to decide. Leave a comment below on what you guys think about it. So, next one. A human body only contains over 30 elements, but an Apple iPhone contains over 75 elements in it. It is actually 2/3 of the periodic table. An iPhone contains about 0.03 grams of gold, 0.34 grams of silver, 0.0003 grams of platinum. In 2015, Apple recovered over 1,000 kilograms of gold from broken iPhones, which is $40 million worth. So that brings us to the end of the video. Apple's history has been astonishing. It has made a lot of ups and downs on its way. Now, it's one of the most powerful players in the computing and the smartphone industry. So guys, if you like this video, thumbs up would be amazing. Share it to your friends. And if you want to see more videos like this, mention it in the comment section. Leave a comment below on what you guys think about this video. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Once again, my name is Rohit and this is TechVortex. And I'll see you guys in the next one.